We still have a culture that says math is for boys, you know, that being into computers isn't cool. And so there's not enough, I think, encouragement that's happening, both amongst families, amongst educators, amongst society, that are telling girls, you can be a creator, you can be an innovator, you can build something. I also think that the way that we raise our girls has to change. And I have a book coming out called Brave Not Perfect in February, which really talks about this, is that, you know, from the time that we're 30 months old, girls are taught to, like, even when they're building Legos, they're taught to build very stable structures that have, like, a story with it. Boys are just taught to, like, build high and, like, break it down. And so from a young age, we coddle our little girls. And so we give them accolades when they do something right. And so when we start gravitating towards things that we don't think we're good at, we immediately think it's not for us. And so how do you teach girls that risk quotient really early on? And I think that when we change our parenting, we change the way we educate our young girls to be risk takers, to be imperfect, right? To be bold, to pick the scary thing, like, you're going to inspire a generation of change makers and entrepreneurs.
To that point, how do you retrain someone that's, let's say, 30, 35,
yeah,
that was raised, just like,
yes,
you mentioned, how do you,
yeah,
change their mindset?
That's me. Like, I was raised that way. I did everything right until I woke up at 33 and I was like, I'm not happy. Wait, I'm supposed to be happy. I got the right job. I got the right school. I did everything I was supposed to do. Why aren't I happy? Why aren't I satisfied? And I ran for Congress. I lost miserably. And I was humiliated, but I didn't die. And I was like, oh, like, I can actually fail and, like, live to fight another day. So what I learned is that bravery is like a muscle, right? If you keep putting yourself out there, you keep trying things, you keep getting rejected, you keep failing, that at least you're living a joyful life without regrets. And I think that that's what this is about. We have the largest incidence of, we have like a mental health crisis with young women and with women in general, because we thought we did everything right when we're waking up and realizing we don't feel satisfied. And there's something liberating about doing something new. I can't swim, but I've been taking surfing lessons. And every time I get there on the board, I barely get up, but it feels so awesome to try something that I don't think I was good at, but to learn again, to feel that sense of challenge, and to realize that even though I'm 42, it's not over for me. Like, I still have this enormous life that's ahead of me to experience things that I never thought that I would be able to do. And that's joyful.
Kind of last but not least, why is an event like this important?
I think that I have seen so much warmth and community amongst people here in Indianapolis, in terms of, like, they're really committed to build this tech ecosystem, and they're doing it together. And when you see something like that, like, I'm just like, raise my hand, I want to be a part of it. Like, what can I do to inspire the community to have more girls who code clubs, to raise their girls differently, right? To have men stand up and be allies for this incredible movement. Like, there's something really magical that's happening here in Indianapolis, and I was happy to be a part of it for 45 minutes.